What did you think of that? Does anybody call you the Groupster?
Hey guys. Yeah, sometimes.
All right. Okay, so it's not that bad. Listen, you've been playing fantastic hockey lately. How do you feel out there? Is this the best you felt all season?
Yeah, it's been working out the last couple of games. Obviously, we've been playing really good as a team. Guys are letting me see the puck really well, so that makes the job easier for me.
Yeah, you know, we did a little bit of a breakdown, a tape of some of your top saves over these last couple of games. You were really good against the Blackhawks, both in the first part and the second part of that back-to-back. It seems like when we watch, it seems like you are really dialed in right now. Do you feel that way on the ice?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, things weren't really working out the first half of the season, so you got to take a step back and reassess your game. And that's what I did. And sometimes when things aren't really working out too much, you try to even harder to make it work and try harder. And sometimes less is more, and that's how I've been approaching it. So if you look at the standings, we're in a battle every night. It's game seven every night. So every situation, every shift for every guy is crucial out there.
You know, Philip, as somebody who follows the game pretty closely, I can't help but draw the parallels to this season and really last season for you. Because if we go back in time to 17-18, you're kind of carrying an important part of the goaltending load down the stretch as you head into the postseason. How much does your experience in the second half with Washington kind of inform what you're doing on the ice for the Avs today?
Yeah, like you said, similar situation with the Caps and what it is now. Obviously, we have a couple experienced guys in that room, and like I said, it's game seven for a couple teams out there right now. I'm battling for a playoff spot. You try just to look at game by game. You can't look any further, and you can't look back. If you lost a game, you got to win the next one. You got to make sure you got to get points. And individually in the room, it's been really great, and we're looking forward to the next game.
And right now, it seems like you're the guy. I mean, you've been the guy that's been called upon to go out there game after game over these last couple. I mean, that's probably got to make you feel good, too, that you feel like, hey, I want this responsibility, and the coaching staff and the team really believes in me right now.
Yeah, absolutely. Like, you want to play. Everybody wants to play, but there's only one goalie who can play. But it's really nice to play a couple games in a row. You get into a flow, you get into a rhythm, and try to keep that going and try to get a win for the guys and get us in a good spot. And
Philip, injuries to a couple of key guys like Landeskog and Rantanen it doesn't come at an opportune time necessarily, but I'm curious to know, if you let us inside the room, how does Coach Bednar address this? Is there maybe an increased emphasis on defensive structure and the way you play inside your zone, the way you play inside the offensive zone from a defensive point of view?
Yeah, I think we changed it even before Mikko and Landy got hurt. Like, you need to play defense. You can't just run up the ice all the time. So we needed to play defense. And we changed it around a little bit, and things have been working out. Defense wins you hockey games and wins you championships. So obviously a couple of huge guys for us missing there in the lineup. And it's an opportunity to go for other guys to step up and fill in that role and show what they can do, and hopefully those guys are going to be back soon. But the guys who are playing in those roles right now, they're doing a tremendous job.
All right, Philip, you made the move. You helped the Washington Capitals win a Stanley Cup last year. You end up in Colorado this year. What's the year been like for you? Have you liked Denver? How are the guys treating you? I mean, how has the year been in its on the whole off the ice for Philipp Grubauer with the Colorado Avalanche?
Off the ice, we love it out here. It's always sunny. City's great. Fans are awesome. The guys made me feel like home, like literally the day we came in for the wives too that took us in. That was really generous, and we love it out here and couldn't be any better right now.
You stole my question. I was going to, I'm going to alter
like
my question.
I have a mind reader.
Alter my question on the fly. What is the biggest difference between Washington and Denver?
City-wise?
Yeah, city-wise, not team-wise, city-wise.
Oh, depends. Like, you're a little bit more outdoorsy. You can move to Denver. Probably the sun. It's always sunny. It's always sunny out here. Always nice to get out. In Washington, it was always sometimes a little bit rainy. That's the biggest difference. I could tell you at night on the spot.
Okay.
But both incredible cities. Washington has been home for so many years. Denver's turning into one.
Well, you got a Stanley Cup ring last year. How many guys on the team have, like, asked to try it on? Or is that, like, is that like a jinx thing?
Yeah, taboo maybe.
I don't know. I haven't even brought it in yet. A couple of guys have asked me. It's in my safe and it won't come out.
Yeah, right.
You know what? Smart play by you. Smart play by you. Definitely don't want to lose that. Listen, congratulations on all your success and being named one of the stars of the week. We appreciate the time. Good luck down the stretch here.
Thanks very much. Appreciate it.